everybody, it's Amanda back with Amanda Rose Tarot, and we're here today to do another pick a card reading. The subject or theme is for this reading is going to be your next boyfriend, girlfriend, some information about them. Maybe we never know what's going to come out. Is it going to be, you know, characteristics? Is it going to be what's going on with them? Is it going to be physical appearance? So we just want to know a little bit more about your next boyfriend or girlfriend. And I've done things a little bit differently today. I have three piles, but each pile has 10 different cards. Well, there's a couple, there's two that are the same, the channeled messages. There's two of those, but every other deck is different. So we've got the messenger oracle, we've got the witch's wisdom, we've got healing with the fairies, we've got angels and ancestors, we've got tattoo tarot, we've got the gilded tarot, we've got the gypsy playing cards, we've got the trust your vibes, what else do we have? We've got the gypsy fortune cards, we've got the gypsy playing cards. I just grabbed a bunch of different decks to use. For this reading, I had a comment a little while back. I deleted it immediately, so you guys probably didn't see it, but someone had said, never trust the tarot reader that goes over each card individually. So I don't know what was going on with that person, but I just deleted their comment. It really doesn't make sense to me because a lot of tarot readers just use a few cards, like four cards when they do their readings. And there are other tarot card readers who use multiple cards for their readings. And I really don't think it's anything against any particular tarot reader for the way that they conduct themselves. Everybody has a different way that they prefer to do their readings. So I'm like, what the heck? Okay, I'm gonna try to do a reading with a whole ton of cards and go over each card a little bit less. So we're gonna try it. We'll see how it goes. Maybe I'll actually like this. Maybe I'll like using a ton of different decks. I don't know. It may be confusing, but we'll see. We'll see if we can get some information about your next boyfriend or girlfriend. So we've got three options, like I said. So the first icon is this white flower. The second icon is the Hello Kitty. And the third icon is the ladybug. So I'm just going to give you a second to focus on which icon you're drawn towards. If you're drawn towards more than one, that's perfectly fine. But we will go over and find out who is your next boyfriend or girlfriend. So if you chose the first reading, the white flower, let's just spread out all of your cards, take a look, see what kind of information we can get. So you've got, you're the funniest man I've ever met. I always feel safe when I'm around you. So if you're, you know, looking for a woman, then just change that word to woman. You have the cutest nose. The way your hips sway when you walk is super sexy. Okay, I just want to make sure these are all on camera. We've got the money card. We've got the Empress card. We've got clear the past. We've got the lilies. We've got the Nine of Swords. We've got quiet time. We've got Watchtower of the South, summer. We've got embrace spirits And we've got Fire Guardian. Ignite your passion. Okay. So, all right. So this person, they could be a fire sign, Aries, Leo, Sag. They could be an air sign, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. They could even be an earth sign. Okay, so your next boyfriend, girlfriend. So I think that if you're looking for a woman, I think that something about her body, you know, with the hips, the way your hips sway when you walk, and then the Empress, who is a very, you know, curvy woman. Oh, just one second. Okay, sorry about that. I just wanted to turn my furnace off so it wouldn't interrupt us. So yeah, if you're looking for a woman, I feel like she's going to be very curvy. Okay. Clear the past. So I feel like this is going to be a new person for you. I feel like this is not going to be a person from the past. I feel like you are leaving the past behind. And I feel like whoever this person is, you guys have both kind of been through some kind of traumas. With the Nine of Swords, I get like there's been some trauma in the past. You guys have both had some time to yourself to just kind of reflect on your past. And you're working on kind of clearing that away. I feel like both of you are working on clearing that away. I think that you will meet this person in the summertime. I think it could be around coming, well, Easter isn't really the summertime, but I feel like it could be anywhere between Easter and into the summer, because we've got the lilies and we have the summer card. I feel like you could meet this person someplace where there's lots of flowers. Also, it could be near a stream or a river or some body of water. I feel like, let's see, I feel like this person isn't doing bad financially. I think this person actually has been doing very well financially. So I think this person has been working on clearing out their past, the past relationships that they've had. I think in the past, they went through something that was quite traumatizing, and but they're a person who is able to release the old now and start something new. So I feel like this person has been going through some positive growth, and with the summer card, I do feel like you're gonna have a lot of happiness with this person. And we also got something about the funniest man I've ever met. So either, you know, man or woman, I feel like this person, they're gonna bring out your laughter again. And I feel like they haven't laughed in a while either. So you guys both, when you start dating this person, the feelings of the past are gonna kind of fade away. And those hurt feelings are going to dissipate, and there's going to be a lot of passion between you guys with Ignite Your Passion. I feel like, wow, this is going to be like a steamy connection. There's going to be a lot of warmth also with the summer card, so I feel like pay attention in the summertime or anywhere between Easter and throughout the summer for someone that you meet. This person could also have a lot of tattoos. We've got tattoos all over this person. So this person could have tattoos. Embrace spirits. So I think both of you are very spiritual. I think that this person will, they're into the whole hippy-dippy stuff, like, you know, you're just a person living your life into peace and love, and you guys are both going to be very laid back, I feel, but also very passionate for each other. So you could be shocked by this person, how much they're attracted to you. Like, they notice the way you walk, they think, you know, your nose is cute, and they also feel safer around you. So I feel like, or vice versa, you feel safe around them, because they could have been through something traumatic in the past, or you could have been through something traumatic in the past, and you've released that, but also you get memories of it. But this person is going to make you feel safe, so I feel like you won't have to worry about the traumas of the past. Like, you've survived those traumas, and this person, I think that they're going to be like your rock. They're going to make you feel safe. They're going to make you feel very desired, and this is going to be a meaningful relationship. So this person also, with the lilies, I feel like they're going to, they're going to really want to probably be very spiritual with you. Maybe you guys will attend church or mass together, because the lilies is about, you know, your spirituality. So it's like, with Embrace Spirit and the lilies card, I feel like you guys both are going to be very, very spiritual people. Let's see. What else? Yeah, this is the thing, when you use a lot of different cards, it can be so much, you know, going on all at once. But yeah, I feel like you guys are both going to be very spiritual. This is going to be a meaningful relationship. You guys are both going to be very enlightened. You guys are both going to be optimistic. And let's see what else. I think that this new passion is going to bring new life into you. It's going to make you feel whole again, where with the Nine of Swords in the past, you could have felt like, you know, you're kind of breaking down, like, emotionally. But this person is going to stir your love again, your passion again. There's going to be hot energy, like fire energy. So like I said, this person could be Aries, Leo, Sag. That's what I'm feeling most strongly. This person's also going to have a lot of strength. It could be physical strength, power. And this person's just going to ignite your inner flame. And you guys are going to have so much fun and, you know, enjoying the summer together. Just enjoy this, because I feel like it's going to be a reward after, you know, going through some bad things. I think this is really going to be like kind of a reward for you when you find this person. Also, money's not going to be a problem, so you guys could travel. You guys could go to warmer climates with the summer card. I feel like some of you will be traveling to like warm tropical locations. And I feel like spiritually and materially, you guys will not have any problems. You guys are going to be very secure with your spiritual side and also your material side. I think you guys both are going to like to meditate and pray, and you guys are both going to probably be into like the afterlife, like, you know, what happens after you pass away. That's just something else that I'm kind of getting. Something to do with Easter, though. You know, it's like after the winter when, you know, everything starts growing again. And there's going to be a sense of, like, newness about this. There's going to be, like, a sense of innocence that I'm getting also with the summer card. So it's coming from a time of, like, hibernation and clearing out the past. And then igniting your passion again, so things like start to grow, and they grow super duper fast. So this thing, you could meet this person, and then things just they take off, and it's like they're out of control, like not in a bad way, but in a good way. And you're just gonna feel so happy and so protected from this person, safe. And you'll be able to be vulnerable. So that's what I'm getting. I know it's kind of, I don't do my readings like this typically, but I just wanted to try something different. So let me know if you like that, if you pick number one. Thank you so much for coming. Okay, so if you pick number two, the Hello Kitty, let's see about your next boyfriend, girlfriend. Can we get some information? We've got everything else in the last reading, so let's see. Darling, any lady won't do. I need you. I want you to be confident. Do it. Okay. So even if you're looking for a man, just plug that in to suit that. I wish I was half the human you are. These memories of you won't stop. So this could be a person from the past. They remember you. You've got the Constancy card. You've got the Chariot card. So it could be a Cancer sign. Pull these down a little bit. You've got Be Grateful. Got the Marriage card. Hopefully you guys can see these. I'm trying to keep them in frame. You've got the Eight of Cups reversed. Okay. Like I said, this could be someone from the past. You've got Problems Resolved. Wow. You've got the Chalice, Fulfillment. Wow, you guys, these are great cards. I'm so happy. You guys, you've got Trust in Magic. I don't know if you guys can see all these cards. Okay, one more. Father Sky. Okay, so this is the hard part when we have a ton of cards, is trying to fit them all in so you guys can see them all. But I think that's pretty good right there. I'm trying to, oh no, you guys can't see this card. Okay, I think that's good. Okay, I think that's good. So, your next boyfriend, girlfriend is going to be someone from the past, okay? With the Eight of Cups, and also we have here these memories of you won't stop in the channeled message. So, definitely this is a person of the past, but I think it's like a restart, like starting over again, starting from scratch. And fixing the problems that you guys initially had the first time you were together, because we've got the Problems Resolved. So it's like recognizing the worth of the other person. We've got Be Grateful. So it's like just be grateful that this person is in your life. So it's like if you guys had problems in the past, I feel like you guys resolve these problems just because you guys want to be together. So we get the Constancy card. So it's like they don't want you to go anywhere. They want you to be with them. And so it's like they're just going to be grateful that you're there with them. So I feel like you guys kind of, you were together and then you separated and they went away. And while they were away, I feel like there was a lot of growth between you and them. I feel like you guys both kind of grew as a person, and I feel like your confidence kind of grew as well, and their confidence kind of grew, and they just want to be with you is what I'm getting. They want to actually marry you. So they don't just want to be with you. They actually want to marry you. Be grateful. So this person, they're so grateful that if you would take them back, because I feel like it's going to be a choice for you to actually take this person back. And they could be worrying about that. They could be worrying, will this person take me back? Maybe they didn't appreciate you the way they should have when you guys were together. And they just enjoy your company. They love being with you. And they just want to ask, like, can you please take me back? You know, I feel like they had anxiety while you guys were separated, and they tried to trust in magic, you know, that they could manifest this back together, or they could somehow fix this. So they were kind of trusting in magic. Also, we've got Father Sky, and it says trust in the unknown. I don't know if you guys can see that. Trust in the unknown. So this person, they trust in magic and trust in the unknown. So this person, they're really trying to keep the faith that, you know, the problems would be resolved, and, you know, that they could come back around and come back to you, because they feel like they went away, and but they want to come back. They want to come back so badly. With the constant card, it's like they didn't stop thinking about you even when you guys were separated, because it says these memories of you won't stop. So they still constantly think about you, even when you're separated. And like this person, maybe at first they weren't very spiritual, they weren't very trusting and in God or in miracles. And I think while they went away, they kind of they mastered their spirituality, or they were working on their spirituality, and they were listening to their intuition. And it's like they knew this was their destiny to come back to you. And so while they were distancing themselves, they never stopped thinking about you. And this was a troubled relationship, but I still feel like there was enough love there to make it work. So I feel like they just want to have faith that you guys can work it out. Maybe you guys can start over again from scratch. And this person needs you. I feel like this person needs you. They were feeling alone without you, and I think sincerely they will tell you that. They'll tell you that they're grateful just to have you, okay? And they never want to lose you again, is what I'm feeling here. And they want to marry you. They really want to marry you. They want everybody to know that you are theirs. They want you to wear a ring, you know, so that everybody can see that you guys are meant for each other, and that other people, like, it's like put a ring on it so everybody knows. And they just feel like you guys belong together, and this partnership is something that they will be committed to. With the constancy card, they will be committed to you. And they've reminisced about you so much, and they want this to be a lifelong thing. They don't want this just to be something that They keep coming and going. They really want to put a ring on it. And I think you guys will have a happy marriage together. This card really predicts a happy marriage. Even if you guys broke up, I feel like you guys will start all over again. And let's see, this person, as far as physical characteristics, let's see, this person, I feel like they could have blue eyes. They could have blue eyes. They could like pets, like snakes. I don't like snakes, but they could like snakes. I feel like they see a lot of synchronicities. Like they see, they're very spiritual, like I said. So I think they see a lot of synchronicities, like animals. This person, they could wear a lot of purple. Like we got purple. They could like to wear purple, or maybe that's their color. Maybe they look really good in purple. This person, they could have longer hair. They could have longer hair. They could be older. They could be older than you. That's all I'm getting. So I hope you like this reading. I just wanted to switch it up, do something different for a change, and just throw a bunch of cards on the table and see what we get, right? So thank you so much, number two. Okay, last but not least, if you pick the ladybug, let's see your next boyfriend, girlfriend, what can you expect? Who knows what we'll get. You make me want to be a better person. Please never stop being you. Your touch is healing. Your presence is reassuring. When you enter a room, the energy shifts. Wow. You've got some money. You've got the Page of Swords. You've got get a new story. You've got the, I call it sickle, but I don't think that's how you say it. You've got the Knight of Coins. You've got peace of mind. You've got passion. Ooh, hot. You've got dream and journey. And you've got change is unavoidable. Okay. So this person, I feel like you, I don't know if you can see all these cards. This person has been watching you. They could be an earth sign, Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn. They could be an air sign, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. They could be a fire sign, Aries, Leo, Sag. This person, I feel like with the Page of Swords, they have been watching you, maybe from afar. Maybe you have no idea. But this person, they want to be around you. They think that your presence is really reassuring. With the peace of mind, and it says your presence is reassuring, you give this person peace, you make this person calm. Whatever you do, whatever you say, you really help this person to feel better. Get a new story. So this person, maybe they don't like their life story. I feel like this person, something happened in their life, and they just, maybe they don't like talking about it. There's a lot of things in their life that they went through that were negative. So maybe they didn't, if you do know this person, I feel like they didn't tell you a lot about their life. their past. I feel like they're tired of telling people about their story, and they don't want people to judge them. Not that I think that you would judge them, but I think that the stuff that they went through, maybe it was with their family, maybe other people have judged them, so it's like that's why they don't want to talk about it. They had pain, they had suffering, they felt like a victim, and that story, they don't want you to feel bad for them, is what I feel like. So they didn't really talk about that much, but they, when they're with you, they feel so much better. They feel like you're a healer. For some reason, they feel like you are a healer to them. And the things that were in their past, they don't need them anymore. They don't need to think about them anymore. And so they just want to get rid of them. They just want to get rid of them. They don't want to carry that baggage around anymore. So they've had to cut a lot out of their life to heal themselves. But I think that you have helped them in some way, or you will help them in some way. And there's some choice. Okay, sorry you guys. So yeah, I think that you will help this person to kind of cut out their past. I'm not going to keep going on about that. So I think that this person, there's going to be a lot of passion between you. I think this person's going to have the hots for you. I don't know how else to say it. This person thinks you're really sexy. It's been their dream to be with you, so maybe they've just been watching you from afar. But change is unavoidable. So this person, they're going to have to come out of the dark, move into the light. You know, I feel like they want to share, like, responsibilities as far as, like, financially. I feel like they want to share so that it's not, like, a burden on just one person. So I think you guys together would be very solid as far as, like, financially. I think materially they want to help you. So together you guys will be more stable. I feel like they do have a good job, and you probably have a good job, so it's like together you guys will be much more stable. I think that this person, they've been going on some kind of like spiritual journey. They've been having like dreams about you, and it's really keeping them up at night, just these dreams that they keep having about you. And these could be like sexual dreams, like with the passion card. I feel like this person, these dreams are really something that they want to ravish you. I mean, geez, they've been missing you. Even if you guys haven't been together, it's like they want that so bad. That fire, that passion is so strong, and physically they just can't stop thinking about that when they meet you. So there's like lust, passion, attraction, love, warmth between you guys. But they're worried about their past, that somehow their past could mess this up. Like they have so many doubts and worries that somehow their past could screw this up. Maybe what they've done in the past. That's why they want to leave it behind so bad, is because they don't want to slip up and screw things up, because it's like they always, that could be something that they always do, that they always slip up and they always screw up relationships, even if they're good. also, I feel like this person, they don't want to give up on you because they think that you're a person who can help them to get better, and you inspire them to actually achieve their goals, and they feel like you're their destiny, and even if they have to take like a long journey to be with you, they would do that. They would really do that because they've been watching you anyways. I feel like they've been watching you, keeping an eye on you. As far as physical characteristics, this person could be physically very strong. They could have a nice body. They could have light colored hair. They could have tattoos. I know this isn't tattoo tarot, but they could have like a specific tattoo like on their neck. This person, they could wear a lot of like loud clothing, like something that other people wouldn't typically wear. I feel like this person, if you're the female, I feel like they think you're some kind of earth angel, like you were put on this earth to like save them from themselves and their past. And maybe that's why they want to help you out financially. They could have brown eyes. They could have brown hair. They could have blue eyes. They could have like a goatee. Or they could have like their head like shaved a little bit. Curl their hair sometimes, or maybe they have naturally like curly hair, so maybe sometimes they keep it short, but then other times they let it grow out, and sometimes maybe they have facial hair, but then other times they get rid of it. That's all I'm getting, number three. So, thank you. I hope this resonated in some way. I hope you like this. Like I said, I don't typically do readings with, like, 10 cards, but I wanted to do something different for you guys just to switch it up. I'm constantly changing because I feel like that helps out my channel, is if I'm constantly changing things. So, just let me know how you like that. And if you're interested in a reading, then hit me up on my Etsy. You can message me over there. Or you can just order and message through the order. Or you can email me, amandarosetarot@hotmail.com. Or you can check out my Patreon for $5 a month. You get access to a bunch more exclusive videos that I've put out. And I think I'm going to put another one out today over there. And I think I'm going to use the Tarot of Sexual Magic over there. So if you're interested in that, then go check it out. So thank you so much. Love and light. And I will talk to you soon. Bye-bye.